Remember this, if Biden wins, the violent mobs, you see these mobs all over the place. They're Biden people. They're Biden states and cities. They're Democrat states. If they win, the mobs win.
As the president yet again pushes his message of fear and violence, columnist Eugene Robinson writes the following, quote, "All of this is nothing less than undisguised white supremacy. Trump wants white voters to fear the Black Lives Matter movement. He wants them to see it not as a demand for justice and fairness, but as a moral threat to white privilege, to fear the very concept of white privilege as some kind of attack." Back with us again tonight, Eugene Robinson, Pulitzer Prize-winning columnist for The Washington Post, and Steve Schmidt, veteran political strategist who led John McCain's 08 campaign effort, has since left the party. He was among the founders, in fact, of the Lincoln Project, dedicated to the defeat of Trump and Trumpism. Eugene, like you, I continue to be amazed at how much ambiguous reporting there is of this president. The line you have authored is unambiguous, undisguised white supremacy. Explain.
Well, what President Trump is doing is completely undisguised. I mean, look at his approach to the racial justice protests. Protesters are all moms and anarchists, and he's all but called them bad hombres, I guess. He's completely his entire message is law and order. It's that you, white Americans, who might be made uncomfortable by some of this, you're being persecuted, you're being set upon, your communities are being put in danger by the protests, and not just by the protests, but by the very idea that there is such a thing as systemic racism in the United States, and he rejects that, and he wants his voters to reject that too, and to be frightened of it. He's campaigning on a pledge not to enforce the 1968 Fair Housing Act. He's promising not to enforce that law, and saying that if Biden, the Democrats, are elected and do enforce the law, as every president since 1968 has enforced the law, the suburbs will be destroyed because they'll move low-income housing next to you in your frankly white suburb. It's barely coded language for Black and brown people will be moving next door, and they will bring crime and drugs. We haven't seen as explicitly racist a national campaign as this one since George Wallace's campaign in 1968, with the exception that Wallace was perhaps a bit more subtle and sophisticated in his rhetoric than Donald Trump is.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.